Awesome. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to welcome Michael Stonebreaker to the show. I know this is a guest that we've been looking forward to a while now since we started bringing Irv Smith and being a part of the team. Going on from your time at Notre Dame, you were third in the Buckus balloting. What does it mean for you to be, because we've talked to Heisman Trophy winners like Tim Brown, we talked to Lou Holtz, who won quite a few Coach of the Years. What was it like for you to be up for in a situation where you were up for a major college football award?
I mean, it's fun and exciting, you know, for an individual. You know, it's an honor. It's a good honor. But, you know, what it does is it reflects on, for me, it reflects on the team. It reflects on our defense, how good and how dominant our defense was. Now, you know, and that was my whole time at Notre Dame. I don't want to correct you, but I finished third place in the balloting twice for the Buckus Award. So, you know, what that meant was we had some pretty solid defense. You know, we had some pretty consistently good defense because, you know, for a linebacker, if your defensive lineman isn't holding up the defensive lineman, you know, forcing a double team on certain plays, then the offensive linemen are going to more easily be able to get off and get to the linebacker. So, you know, it's the whole concept of the defense that is going to allow, you know, a linebacker to make his reads and get and make the tackle. So, you know, it's a team award, just like all of them are, MVP, you know, in basketball. You know, it's all a team award.
You were part of arguably the best defensive set of all Americans we've ever seen. For those who haven't seen this list, Michael was a part of the all Americans with my favorite non-Notre Dame linebacker of all time, Derek Thomas, prime time himself, Deion Sanders, and Broderick Thomas. When you look at that list, what does it say for you as far as perspective of how good of a season you had being mentioned with these great NFL Hall of Fame names?
Well, if when you're mentioning those guys and you're mentioning the Buckus Award, I finished third behind Derek Thomas and Broderick Thomas. Now, both of those guys were outside linebackers that rushed the quarterback. You know, they weren't inside linebackers that played, you know, in the trenches. So, you know, I think there should be two awards for, you know, linebackers, because there's a big difference between an inside linebacker and a linebacker that is on the corner rushing, you know, trying to get sacked every time. But, you know, being mentioned with those guys and going to the award banquets with those guys, you know, it was fun. We all had a good time. We all gelled good together. You know, you're up there with guys who you know how to play the game of football and are doing it at a high level. So, you know, it's always fun to be able to, you know, take pictures with guys and meet guys off the field. But like I said, you have to be a good, solid team defense in order for one person to get those accolades, or in order for, you know, to get the notoriety that it takes in order to be, you know, even nominated for those kind of awards. So, you know, it's fun. It's fun being a part of that.
Your last days of football were playing for the Frankfurt Galaxy. That was part of the World League. You got to be a little overtime in Europe. What was it like playing in Frankfurt? Do you enjoy it? Do you miss it? Do you ever go back?
It was fun. I was over there with some good guys. Paul Justin, he and I got drafted by the Bears together. He was our quarterback. Jason Miller was another one of our quarterbacks. He went on and played with the Bears after the Frankfurt game. But it was fun. We were living in Germany for 3 months. We went to the pub behind the hotel and drank German beer, you know, every day after practice. And we were able to travel around Europe and see all the different cities and have a good experience. And, you know, and the fans over there were really good. It was a new thing. They packed the stadium every night. They didn't know what they were cheering about. They cheered at, you know, sometimes the right, sometimes the wrong times, but, you know, the fans had a lot of energy. All the fan banquets that we had, you know, they were always packed. So it was a lot of fun being over there. You know, Coach Holtz is an offensive coach, and he spent most of his time down with the offense. So our goal every day at practice was to keep him down in the offensive side of the field, which made our practices a little looser and a little, and a little easier on us. But that's because we, you know, when it was time to practice, when it was time to go through your reads, when it was time for 7-on-7 drills, you know, all the drills, you know, he demanded that we did everything right and that we did it as hard as we possibly could. And so, you know, Barry was one of the only coaches, that after practice, when I had my downtime, you know, sometimes you want to kind of avoid the coaches and avoid the coaching offices and everything. But, you know, we would go in there and hang out with him and watch film in his office and spend time with him because, you know, he's that kind of guy. He's a player's coach. He's a good person. You know, he cared about us as individuals. But, you know, as far as practicing, we had a good time. But when it was time to go through our reads and get it right, you know, we definitely practiced really hard. Wes and Frank like to think that they would get over me. See, I was strong enough that I could see the straight guy in all of their jokes, right? So, you know, they could play all their pranks on me and have a good time with it, but it didn't faze me at all because I was focused on the task at hand. So, you know, we had a good time. You know, Wes and Frank and I, we got along really well. You know, you couldn't ask as a Eagle linebacker, basically the weak side linebacker that I played. To have a guy next to you that's 6'5", you know, 250 pounds, who can take on a guard and smash the guard, knock him back in his tracks, you know, that freed me up a lot, you know, to get around and make a lot of plays. So, you know, and then with Frank on the end there, you know, stuff in the end, you know, they couldn't beat Frank to the outside. You know, he was strong all the way. He was quick all the way down the line. So, you know, I couldn't have asked for a better situation than to have those two guys on the field and off the field. Actually, when I was on my recruiting trip, Wes Pritchett was my host. And so I got to spend the weekend with Wes. And after spending the weekend with Wes at Notre Dame, you know, that really did help me solidify my choice on choosing Notre Dame.